What's up, everybody? John with Green Abbey Rolling, and today we are sitting in Phoenix. I just got delivered this morning, about an hour ago. I was sitting in Mesa, Arizona, and delivered some roof shingles. It is Thursday. I had three loads this week, and I've already grossed to me $1,900. And I am now waiting to get loaded at Final Tech, getting a load of pipe. I really don't like pipe. It's easy load. I mean, it's straps. So you belly strap, and I would say crisscross the strap. So all your straps. So your belly straps, the one from one side, the other from the other side, crisscross, and then when they do the next tiers, multiple straps from both directions. So that way you're pulling, as you tighten on one side, it doesn't cause the load to lean as you're tightening it, and then the other side, you know, so you kind of combine each other. And even though the loaders will do their best to stack them nice and neat and tight packed, when you tighten down, you're pulling from one side to the other, and the little bit of gap will then show, you know. And pipe is so light, and because everything's, there's so many gaps in between the pipes, in between each other, if you don't, there's like, you could over tighten it because it's plastic and it could crack the pipe, which is bad. It's like drywall, you know, you don't over tighten, you'll crack the drywall. But with pipe, if you don't tighten it enough, you'd leave it too loose, when you do a turn, it's like mesh wire, it'll sway right or left. And trust me, you don't like that. You don't want that to happen. So it's like, you gotta be careful. I typically, from here, I get it tight how I feel it should be good, and I take the turns as slow as possible, getting out of here. And when I think it's 3 miles down the road to the Flying J, I'll get parked up, and I'll re-tighten everything up again. Sometimes you get a notch or two, a little extra, but you really gotta watch your pipe. And also, it depends on the diameter of the pipe. I mean, you get the big pipe, then you can kind of crank it down a lot more than the smaller pipes. The smaller pipes will actually indent and kind of crush the pipes. So keep that thought in mind. There's a love and a hate. You love them because it's just throwing straps. But then again, you hate when you got a tarp it. And here, there's no tarping station. And what they do is you grab these bags that they use. The pipe is made out of a powder. There's a facility here that literally is building the pipes, making the pipes, and it first comes in like a powder, and there's huge white bags, and when they're done using, emptying the bags, they have a pallet, just a pile of them. So we use the bags as your smoke tarp, even though our trucks don't smoke, but you gotta follow the EPA to code rules. Cause back in the day, they used to blow black smoke, you know, out the pipes, and then they don't want that black diesel exhaust going through the pipes that are going to be having water run through them, and we drink, you know, water out of the pool, or out of the faucets at the house and everything, so that's the whole purpose of the smoke part, is to keep the chemicals from your exhaust penetrating the water pipes that we use to bathe, to drink, to cook our foods, you know, all that stuff. So we use these bags. We bungee the front of the tarp up, or the pipes up, instead of smoke tarp here. Other locations where I delivered or actually I picked up in Mississippi, similar stuff, same company, I think. They actually had a tarping station to throw your smoke tarp on. It's no big deal. Really easy. Does take a little while. Takes more time of the load because you got to throw on the whole fall harness and cable yourself up. But anyway, all right. It's Thursday. I have now like 4 hours left. Less than 4 hours because it took about 30 minutes to get here. So less than four hours of my day left before I got shut down for my 10. I got 30, over 30 hours left of my 70 for the week. All right, and it's only Thursday. So I got plenty of hours. They gave me a load here. I'm going somewhere in Colorado. And hopefully it's a delivery for Monday. So I get my good 34-hour reset in, and like I said, I'm already at 1,900 to me, at 35%, because right now my snapshot, I'm going to show you right now. All right, so that was my snapshot. It says 33%. Now, what they don't show you is the extra 2% they're throwing on the back end for me staying out for the whole month of June up until July 3rd. So the goal is stay away from the home, you roll for the whole month, and hopefully I'm home for 4th of July to celebrate. And they add the 2% on for the month of June for staying out. So even though it says 33%, I'm getting 35% per load, and I just grossed so far 1,900 to the truck on three loads this week, and this will be my fourth load, which again I don't have the information yet of the load when it delivers, but I don't see myself driving throughout the night and making it from here to wherever in Colorado. It kind of depends. It's not easy. With a restricted truck, and then even though the load's light, a restricted truck, you gotta go up to Flagstaff, and I happen to notice right now East Arizona, the mountain terrains, like over by Sholo, and I think it's Gallup, not Gallup, Grants. I don't know. I didn't pull out the map, but East Arizona, the mountain terrains, it's all under fire. So there's a ton of smoke. It's probably not gonna be a pleasant night to sleep with the windows down and, you know, not idle. So that's gonna suck, because I get out of here, get up north a little bit, it's cooler at night, you don't have to run the motor and you know, save the fuel. Even though I just left Irving, Texas the other day, 2 days ago, drove all day yesterday and all morning, and I delivered here in Mesa, the truck was showing 9 miles to the gallon. That's pretty good for being loaded at a gross of 77,000. So I don't know what the shop may have done, but I'm getting pretty good fuel mileage right now. And like I said, I just, well, went on 2 weeks now. Yeah, 2 weeks ago, I think, I had another PM service, so I don't know if it's just new oil filter, just the altitude, or Max just loves Arizona. That's it. Max just loves the dry, warmer temperatures. You could keep that East Coast. That's it. I'm gonna stick with that one. I'm hoping that I get a load from Colorado to California so I could see the girls. The last time I was able to, actually the only time I was able to see my girls so far last year, happened to be a Colorado Springs to Salinas, California load. And from Salinas, California, I went up to, I think it was Union City, is over there by Oakland Bay area, picked up a load of pipe, and then that took me all the way to Idaho. Yep, Idaho. And I was able to get to Sacramento, park up for the night, and my daughters were able to show up for dinner, so we went out and had a good time that one time. So fingers crossed for me, I get to do that again. I already kind of threw out the note to the fleet manager, hey, that would be freaking fabulous. Plus I was able to, unfortunately, I had to do my 34-hour reset on the way to Salinas in Las Vegas, California, or Las Vegas, Nevada. But things have changed, you know, with this whole COVID. Things are still closed up. It'd be weird. Don't really want to hang out in a... I hate hanging out in truck stops on the weekends. If you're following me, I typically love going to, for the weekend, if I could find the customer that allows parking on property for the weekend. Before I get there, I'll do the whole shower, shave, clean myself up, do my laundry, clean the truck, then park up for the weekend at the customer. And thank God for things like Uber and Uber Eats and Lyft, because, you know, get out of the truck, get some exercise, I'll go and actually walk. What sucks is if I'm at a truck stop, that's great if I'm within walking distance to getting out, you know. Well, like I said, I went to movie theaters and stuff that was open, but now things are kind of closed up. So, but you still get out, get some fresh air, get some exercise, go to the walk around a park, walk around town, the old towns that are all historic. But the whole point is just get out, get some exercise, and it helps raise your spirits too. You know, that's lately my issue is pretty depressed. I'm missing my girls. Been with TMC a whole year and only one time. That's depressing. And now with the whole COVID thing, I have a week vacation, but my daughters would have to fly out to me, and I'm not okay yet with my daughters flying in the aircraft all the way from California to Arkansas with my oldest having asthma. And she already has this asthmatic issue. I don't want her taking that chance of catching COVID and having all that issues. So we're still kind of waiting until more of a vaccine or this clears up more. But right now it's just a depressing situation for me. I wish I could see them. I wish they got to go. Apparently they went up in the mountains, rented a cabin, and was, you know, having fun. They'd be doing that with me if I could get them to Arkansas, because we have a lake house and we'd be hanging out in the lake, canoeing, kayaking, fishing, being outdoors, you know, all the good stuff too. That was the plan. It's just, I can't bring them to me, and I can't afford to go to California, fly out, rent a car, stay in a hotel, and then also have money to go figure out what to do with everything still closed up. It just really sucks. Bottom line, it just sucks. So that's why I've been a bit depressed and frustrated. I might just have to wait until next Christmas. So we have a Christmas run as well. So the month of December, if you stay out till December 23rd, you get an extra 2% added to your pay. And then from the 23rd through January 2nd, so you got Christmas and New Year's off, you'll be home. Now, if I save my 1 week vacation and then just add it after that, depending on, again, I guess their school situation, I'll just stay out. But anyways, that's months away. Bottom line is, things have improved with the trucking industry out here, at least for me. I'm back on top. I'm in the top 4% of the whole company. I'm grossing nearly $2,000. Now, is it regular? No, it's more like $15,000 to $2,000. It fluctuates basically where you're at and what the loads you get. My fleet manager did try to get me on an Ohio load, and he knows how where I was at. I was like, I don't want an Ohio load. I want a west load. I was in Texas. So there's got to be something going west. So initially I had Texas to Ohio paying $1,200 to the truck. And then I was like, tell them, whoever, planner, I want west. 15 minutes later, boom, $3,300 load to the truck going from Texas to Arizona. How about that, right? That's what I'm talking about. So sometimes straight up communication, but not negative communication. Don't argue, don't fight. You never know what they actually have in planned in mind. And you also never know, because you don't have any control over seeing the load board, of what is actually available. It is a bit concerning to me, a bummer, when I speak with drivers. I'm looking at a TMC owner operator right now getting loaded, but apparently he lives here in Arizona, so he gets those loads all the time from Pryor, Oklahoma to Phoenix, delivers and picks up Phoenix going elsewhere. It's Thursday, so he's probably going to stay out a whole another week before he's home again for Friday. But to hear other drivers literally tell you, I was just in California, I was just in Sacramento, I was just there, I was just, there's loads that goes from Medicine Lodge to California, Long Beach all the time. Why don't I ever get those? Oh, because there's owner-operators that live out there, so they have to get those. Oh, I see. So, do I gotta move again? Hopefully no. Maybe I just keep sticking it out, dealing with the way it is. I like TMC. I like the work. I like the pay. Of course, there's policies and things that I don't agree with, but I'm a company driver right now, so like they'll tell you. Any boss will tell you, oh, if you don't like it, you can go. You can leave. So I'm not at that point yet. So I'm still enjoying what I'm doing. Making the best of it. Again, continuing to prove to myself and my fleet manager and the load planner, if they pay attention, I get stuff done. I'm not a slacker. sure there's times where I had to drive and I'm like, I need to park. I get a power nap in, even if it's just an hour. I need to park, get a power nap, wake up, refreshed, re-energize. Sometimes just getting something to eat, a coffee, stretch your legs, get the blood pumping, and then go again. Always keep in mind, the earliest you leave out on Sunday to be parked up for Monday starts your week off right, where you make the most. A fresh clock Monday morning and empty is music to your fleet manager and the load planner's ears. Because again, the goal is either five mediocre to great paying loads getting unloaded first thing in the morning, loaded before noon, and pretty much all the way to the customer before you run out of hours. So that way you can be unloaded first thing in the morning and repeat yourself the whole week. But again, keep in mind, sometimes my fleet manager will call me up and give me options. Just because one load pays more than the other loads does not necessarily mean that's the best route to go. So always keep that in mind. Don't get money hungry on one load when you could go, well, I could get this other load that pays maybe even if it's just half as much, but I could literally pick it up today and drive pretty much all the way and deliver first thing in the morning to another location where I know that you got more loads out of that area compared to one load that picks up today. You drive a day and a half, maybe even 2 days, for something that pays twice as much as that one load, when in the end, you could almost make three times as much for the whole week. So, never get enticed on just what that one load pays. Think of the big picture. All right, it's 100 degrees. I got the window down. I'm hot. I was hoping the food truck would have arrived, but it looks like the food truck is probably already gone. I'd kill for a torta, man. I'd kill for a carne asada torta, some tacos. I love the West. All right, this is John with Green. I'd be rolling. Have a great one. Always look for the positive. Stay away from the negative. And add one more thing to your daily pre-trip or your planning of your trip. Check to see if the route goes through major metropolis areas that are protesting. All right, stay away from those closed roads. Stay away from all that BS. Be good to each other. Don't let other people's ignorance get to you. Get the job done. Get home. Get with your family. John with Green, I'll be rolling. Out.